Another helpful project that you can look at is your enrollment and scheduling project. In the enrollment and scheduling project, you have two workbooks. One is specific to course enrollment. This is going to be probably more beneficial to our secondary schools. And then you have a broader DCSD enrollment. I will walk you through some of the features on this. In a workbook, I always click on the very first piece because you're going to have tabs at the top that would take you into each individual workbook. Okay, so here you're going to see your overall district enrollment data broken out by grade level, low SES, subgroups. You're also going to see all of your race and ethnicity on this side. You're important to know with all of this entire project is that it also has filters to the side. So you can filter down to a specific school, but there's also a workbook that's going to give you specific school data. So you could look at, again, picking one grade level. If we just wanted to look at elementary or just at high school, you're going to be able to see that there. Very important is the effective date. It always defaults to the last day of the school year. And so this data is as accurate as our enrollment data is in campus. It's pulling it in from the prior night's upload. So it's very current. But if you wanted to do some comparison to see how African Americans at your school or have changed over time as far as enrollment, you wanted to look at, do you have more females or males? Has that changed in the past 2 years? You could do that by changing this effect date back to the previous year. And you'll see that when I do that, the numbers will change. And then when you click on a new workbook, it's going to keep that effective date that I put in the previous workbook. So just make sure that if you wanted to, you want to change your search, that you are looking at what filters do you have applied so that you're analyzing the data in the right way. So that's the DCSD enrollment. I always go to that back button, and then my default is to go to projects. If I ever get lost, which sometimes happens, I always go back to projects because it's the largest file. So we went through DCSD enrollment. The next one is course enrollment. This is going to be similar as far as looking at the broad lens across the district, but you can drill down into I believe sections, and I think you can also look at this by school. So I could do all students, school year. Yeah. And then if I wanted to look at a specific school here, I can pull up just that specific school. Again, this one is going to be looking at the entire school year. So I'm looking at currently who's enrolled in those courses for this year, but I could go back and look at previous terms. Previous years, previous terms. So interesting data there that you might want to take a peek at to see how your courses are changing over time for enrollment, how our district is evolving with our demographic data.